versions of Motorstorm Apocolypse. I got to have a go at this game last week at a preview event. Even got to meet up with the assistant game director, Simon Barlow. He's a pretty good bloke. Got to talk to him about the game. Okay. I've got to start off saying I don't like racing games. Never liked Need for Speed, Gran Turismo, any of those. They didn't do it for me. The only thing I've liked is Burnout Paradise. And now this. Motorstorm Apocolypse is just balls to the wall, fun action. I love the fun part of the game compared to all the technicalities. You don't have to worry about all the technical aspects. Just, you know, accelerate and go. You're set. Things like this, it is more of an arcade style. I guess that's what makes it better. In this game, they put in a little bit of a story. But, you know, they don't throw it at you. They don't force feed this story to you. It's just, you know, something to carry one map to the other. Told in these comic style cutscenes. Animated looks really, really good. Everything about this game looks good. The visuals in it are absolutely beautiful. Go through day, night cycle, even when you race, like either at the high rise, you've got the sun all around you, down on street level, you've got the mess of the streets. This is set in San Francisco after an earthquake. So you've got all the tables and chairs from all the cafes and restaurants just, you know, lying around on the footpath. You've got gang members, looters, crazy people who refuse to evacuate. They're still in the city and they're causing chaos, throwing Molotov cocktails at you, throwing all kinds of rubbish at you, getting in your way, and you can't hit them. You know, it's not a problem. You can hit them and send them flying. It's all ragdoll physics. Or some of them will hold onto the car. It's fun to just see how long you can drag them along with you. With the environment, like I said, you can take to the rooftops, go through high-rise buildings, jump out of one and into the building of another, stay on street level, drive on the collapsed roads, the highways falling apart, just take any different route that you want, even through the sewers and tunnels, or the collapsed subway system, drive through there. And it's just all fun action, nothing can go wrong. The load times are a little bit slow, but you know, compared to others, it's not that bad. And the steering, I guess, takes a little bit of getting used to, because it is heavier than most driving games, I guess. Now, in this, I'm sure that anyone who's played the other Motorstorm games knows that you can drive all sorts of vehicles. Cars, monster trucks, semi-trailers, bikes, and even like in the bikes, you got the cruisers, race bikes, dirt bikes, all of them, ATVs. You can do stunts, taunt other drivers, mix it up. You can play in multiplayer, 16-player multiplayer, or it's got four-player local. It's got four-player split-screen multiplayer, or in 16-player online. Whole lots of different modes online, races, smashes, all your basic multiplayer things. Also a wager mode, so you can make bets, make money. Use that, you can customize your cars. I mean, the customization doesn't go into as depth and detail of Need for Speed and Gran Turismo, but you can do things, modify your engines and brakes, body kits, paint jobs, logos, all things like that, just to make things a little bit different, make your car different from the other car in multiplayer. Got to play the game in 3D, and the 3D is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, I've wanted to get a 3D TV, but this really pushes the mark. It doesn't do all the cliche obvious things of throwing things at you. It's more, you know, how things are getting better, just going into the screen. It just looks great. Even just the little things, like when you're flying down the street and you've got papers, rubbish, litter, dust, everything just in the air in 3D, and it looks fantastic. It's one of the best 3D implementations I've seen so far. The sound of this game, you know, they've done really good work with the sound. You can smash through things, fire hydrants, people, chairs, furniture. They all sound different. Like the wood sounds like you're smashing through wood. The people, you can hear them groan and crumble up, you know, as you send them flying. Fire hydrants, you hear all the water splashing out. Everything's got its own sound to it, and it's just brilliant. The soundtrack of the game, there is a little bit of licensed music, but not much. Pretty much the whole thing is original soundtrack. They say that they mix it all at Abbey Road, the place where they did the Beatles stuff, and in there they mix up all orchestral music, and that was all done with DJ remixes. So, you know, DJ and all that house crap that you kids like, mixed with orchestra music, actually sounds really well. I mean, it matches the chaos of the game. You can't predict what's coming next in the soundtrack or what's happening in the game. There's all kinds of different fun. In this, like, it's got the difficulty, like easy, medium, hard. But the way they've set it up is through different drivers. Like, you can play as one of three drivers. And each driver is the easy one, the hard one, or the medium one. So you can set it up like that. Some of the best tracks, some of the most memorable tracks that I played, one of the best tracks that I played, even one of the training ones, because there's a few different training modes for online and races. You can be jumping from rooftop to rooftop from ramps using a sports car. You've got the boost on your car. You need to use the boost to make the jumps, but you use too much boost and the car will blow up. You won't be able to make it. And it's just all, you know, all to teach you control, but it's just one of the most clever levels I've seen. One of the clever tracks. Another one is going through darkness. You can't see a thing. It's all going through tunnels, going through sewers, going through a building in a blackout. Things like that. There's dust everywhere. You can't see any of the tracks, so you can't plan anything. All you can do is aim for the little bit of light that you see and hope that you don't smash. Smashing up in this game is why it reminds me of Burnout. It takes a bit of slow motion, crumple up the car, makes it look really good, only this stays in full colour, doesn't go into black and white. Even on bikes, you can see your characters, you know, flying off, then flying off the highway into another car. Anyway, for this game, I say it's highly recommended for anyone with a PlayStation. I mean, I'm not a racing fan, but you know, I'm getting this. And I'll give this as high a score as I can. Anyway, thank you. This is Fluffy for Motorstorm Apocolypse. Good night.